Hey guys, what's going on? It's Kelly back here from MK's Rival Fishing. Today, I'm at the Portage River in Port Clinton, Ohio. Very large river system behind me. I'm gonna be fishing for some largemouth bass today, as well as whatever wants to bite. I'm gonna start with a spinnerbait and a Texas rig crawl. The water is a little bit muddy, a little bit muddier than I would like to see, but I think with our depth finder and our fish catching abilities, we'll be able to prevail today. So let's get out here, let's get some fish, and I'll get back to you guys. Alrighty guys, coming up on a little flat here. My graph is saying it's only 4 foot, so pop a couple casts out there with the spinnerbait, see if we can pull anything off this little flat. Visibility is low. Here's one, guys, got one on up in the wood. Feels like a pretty good fish. Nice one. He came out of the wood, guys. He came out of the wood. That's a good start to the day. Probably fifth cast, sixth cast. He's right up in them sticks, right where he should be on the spinnerbait. And now I'm coming up into a nice location full of dead fish. There's so many dead fish up there. Hook just popped out like that. I'm gonna get a couple pictures to send to the boys and get back to you guys. Nice. Good way to start it, guys. Good way to start it. Just up in the wood, pretty deep on a spinnerbait. And it seems like it's just mega shallow back here. I didn't realize it was gonna be so shallow over on this side. It's kind of weird. So we have two choices. We could go all the way back or we could head out. It's a tough decision to make. I think I am gonna head back just because we did just catch a nice little bass there. And if we don't catch any more back here, we can always move out. I actually have plenty of time to fish today, guys, which is a first for me in a long time. Super nice to have the privilege. It's 100% 1 foot deep over here, so we are going to move to a little bit deeper water. Alrighty guys, I'm actually on a fish right now. I was not expecting to get one up there. It's actually a little bit better fish than the first one. About the same size. Not a bad fish though. It's pretty cool. There's actually like a big carp or something up there that I was casting at, and then this guy came out of that tree and chomped it up. Oh gosh, guys, that was awesome. That's a nice fish. That's a nice fish. Oh my gosh. Oh, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Oh my lord. Chunky. Alrighty fellas, third fish of the day. Pretty nice fish. Maybe pretty close to 2 pounds. Got him swinging this bank with a spinnerbait. Nice fish, guys. Not bad at all. Gonna get her a nice release here. Swam off just fine, guys. Nice fish. Been here literally 30 minutes, 35 minutes, and clapping some fish, clapping some fish. Alrighty guys, so as I've been sitting here, just kind of getting my things back together, getting things put back together, I notice that there is so much bait here in front of me. I mean, there's a ton of bait. I see it coming up everywhere. I'm assuming that there are probably gonna be some more fish up in here. Wherever that bait is usually where the fish are. This time of year though, they are and that pre-spawn migratory behavior, so I don't know. They might be here, they might not. I'm gonna try and fish out a little bit and see if we can't capitalize on this bait ball being here. I don't know if that was a bite or, oh, it was a bite. Oh my gosh, another monster. Let's go. Let's go, guys. Let's go. I didn't know if that was a hit or not. Not gonna get the pole out for this one since we just got one out for another nice one. This one's a lot healthier though. Nice fish. in that bait ball, guys. Right in that bait ball. Scrounging bottom for him. That's a nice one. He's got some pretty cool spots on the back of his fins here. But overall, a very nice, healthy fish. Back to the depths he goes. Into that bait ball. Hammering him, guys. Hammering him. This is going to be a risky cast, but we're going to go for it. Because why not? I lost the spinner bait. It got caught in a foot of water in like some wire or something. So throwing around this big chatter now. Should achieve the same purpose. Big weedless bait that imitates a bluegill or shad. This one much more imitates a shad than our last spinner bait. It's a good looking bait. It should do the same thing. I just am not as confident. Alrighty guys, I'm hooked up. I switched up to a little bit slower bait presentation and hooked up, not immediately, but pretty soon after switching. Come on. We smoked us a little stud, nothing crazy, little guy. Here's I caught him on, guys, just like a Berkeley Havoc crawl. Would love to roll a spinnerbait by that, wish I had one. Up here, but after battling the snakes, got my bait back. Let's see if we can pop a fish out of this tree, maybe. Maybe near the tree. Oh, he's in the tree, guys. Oh, let's go, let's go. That's what I'm talking about, guys. Oh, pig for the chatterbait. I'm right in the corner. Not a bad fish at all, probably 2.5 pounds. Nice fish, guys. Nice fish. Absolute stud of a fish. Pretty good one. Probably pretty close to 2.5 pounds. And there it goes.
I'm gonna kind of slowly fish my way back now, guys, because I think it is going to rain here. It looks pretty menacing and the wind is picking up, but we're gonna give it our all until we leave. We're gonna fish all the way back. And then also maybe if it's not raining yet or the storm looks like it's bowing off a little bit, we can fish that rightmost bank over there and hopefully get on some big bass.
Wow, guys, did you see that? Gosh, I hope I got that on camera. That was insane. He's right there with a snake chilling right there. Oh my gosh, madness.